Welcome to episode 20 of Desert Winds. Kind of hard to believe that we've been going on for this long. Last we left our party, they were battling the big, bad, evil skeleton guy in plate armor that said that they were not going to be there alive. They had recovered life and death lifestone off of the dais, the center of the room, and they've been engaged in battle with skeletons that were regenerating themselves. Since they've managed to recover the lifestone, they're now starting to flee. Leonis has gone unconscious after getting hit by the skeleton. That is where we pick up this week.
And it should be my turn.
Alright. There we were. He had just taken his attack, right? So it's a drawn's action, I believe?
Is that correct? That is correct.
Yes.
The Skeleton King had just taken his action, and now it should be a drawn's turn.
So I'm going to use my last key for the day.
What map are we on?
You are on life, that's fun. Remember the exact name. Life, Death, Lifestone, Temple 2.
Gotcha.
Okay, I'm spending my last key of the day in order to take the disengage bonus action.
Can you hear me?
Should not be. No, I am not. Can you hear me?
And now.
Okay. I was not muted. I don't know why you couldn't hear me earlier. Okay, so I'm spending my last key
Don't forget to push the top when you're talking, if that's your setting.
I am.
So, I lost you again. No.
Hold on. And now?
Gotcha.
Okay, for some reason I have to have TeamSpeak as my primary window. I'm going to restart TeamSpeak.
That's really weird.
Yeah, I'm going to restart TeamSpeak. Let me check the settings, and then I'll restart TeamSpeak just real quick.
Alright guys, thanks for bearing with us while we deal with this technical difficulty.
Okay, so...
So, just a reminder, Quirk has the stone, right?
Yes, I do.
So, yeah, the stream is going to lose you guys for just a moment. Sorry, stream. Just trying to get this all set up. And fortunately, my microphone is independent of TeamSpeak, so you can still hear me, so I can at least keep that going. But should be getting back in just a moment. Okay. Can you hear me now?
Okay. I can hear you now. So.
Good. Okay. So as I was saying, I am spending my last key of the day.
But now I can't.
God damn it, TeamSpeak. Grr! Okay. Can you hear me while it's maximized like this?
Yes.
Okay, I'm just going to have to switch back and forth quickly then. Okay, so I'm spending my last key point to be able to take disengage as a bonus action.
Okay.
And then I'm going to dash over and attack the skeleton king thing.
Okay.
With a real quick, "Don't you go near my sister!" And... Nope, combat. There it is. Actions. Okay, hopefully you can hear me.
Yeah, that hits. Go ahead and roll damage.
Not quite what I had planned yet, but I needed to turn to face me.
Didn't have it targeted. That's what I was just taking a look at. Okay.
Okay, and that will be my turn.
That will be your turn. Okay, so. From the darkness, you guys actually hear a sound very familiar to you as Minotaur skeleton comes running out of this room. Ari, you can take an attack of opportunity if you would like.
Does it run into Ari as it runs?
No, it runs past her.
Yes, okay. I would enjoy taking a attack of opportunity.
Okay.
Let me grab my dice. Sorry if you guys hear this. Oh my god!
We hear it, but it's not bad.
I need to roll in real life more often. I got 19 before adding my mod.
So that's going to be a sort of logical doom strike.
Yeah. I don't even know how to do that without having it all programmed.
It's basically just an extra D8 of damage.
An extra D8? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Let me grab my... Yeah, because I do... Sorry, I'm scrolling through that thing you sent me. There it goes. So I do D10 on a hit, and then plus another D8?
Yes.
Okay. D10. D8. 5.
5 damage?
Mm-hmm.
Really? On a D10 and a D8?
Yeah.
Plus your... What's your strength mod?
Oh, yeah, I didn't even look at my strength mod. Oh, no, my strength mod, I think, is plus one. Yeah.
So six.
So six.
Alright.
Ouch.
You know what? I hit it, guys.
Here, I need to add this guy to the tracker. Already on the tracker somewhere. I gotta find. Apologize. Damage. Alright. So he comes charging past you. Thump, 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 thump. And it started off with his axe dragging on the ground, but as he comes charging forward, you see him swing it up over his head, and right as it's the Skeleton King, he brings it bearing down on the Skeleton King with a bellow. And the Skeleton King, because he heard the thumping and everything, turns to engage him and parries his great axe out of the way. But the Minotaur Skeleton actually lowers his head after the axe is buried away, and he goes to gore the Skeleton King, and again. The Skeleton King just kind of like shoves him off to the side. And with that, Stryker, it is your turn.
Okay, what the actual. Okay. So I can move, attack, and then move, right?
Mm hmm.
Okay. And. Is
I'm
that.
I'm sending you another picture now if you would like to see it.
Sure. Is that Luke next to the giant skeleton thingy?
Yeah, Luke, and then on the other side of it, you've got a drawn. In the north, you've got Leonis.
Oh, wow, this party just got exciting. Okay. Let me see. So that giant minotaur thing, has it acted yet? Technically it hasn't, right?
Yeah, it did. It came charging in and it two attacks against the skeleton king.
Wait, what? Attack the skeleton king?
Yeah, we're all kind of confused by that.
Don't attack the minotaur.
Okay. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm gonna move down 10 feet.
Okay.
So, I guess going down towards Ari, but 10 feet.
Yep.
And then I'm going to shoot the giant evil skeleton king.
Okay.
Thing. So that's 24 to hit.
That hits.
Can has sneak attack. Sneak attack.
Yep. Sneak attack mode engaged.
Okay, that was the shittiest sneak attack roll ever. So I rolled 3 ones, 4, so that's 7 damage.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna use the rest of my movement to get behind giant minotaur skeleton and use my cunning action to hide behind the giant thing.
Okay. So you said it was 7 damage, skeleton king?
Yeah, I rolled 3 ones on a d6.
Okay.
Not rolling too well tonight, are we, party?
It's okay, you guys are just getting started. You'll get warmed up.
And then I'm gonna attempt to hide, use my cunning action to hide behind the giant minotaur skeleton dude.
Okay, go ahead.
That's a 20 to hide. My stealth is 20, and that's the end of my turn.
Alright. Perception is wisdom, right?
Yes.
Yeah, yes. I believe so.
I mean, you feel like you've hidden pretty well behind this minotaur skeleton, and you also get the feeling that because he's so focused on the skeleton king, he's probably not paying much attention to you at all. All right.
Yes.
Skeleton 6. Is that all of the targets have left him, and runs up towards you, Torin.
Saw that coming.
And, he... Bang.
He still had me.
And he misses.
He still had me targeted.
Ready for him, as he comes running up, laughing maniacally, as the skeletons are wont to do. And, misses you.
Oh geez, I am going to take a swipe at the skeleton king.
Okay, go ahead.
Uh,
Oh, no.
I missed. Okay, cool.
How do you want to fail this, Luke?
I want to fail this by totally whiffing on the swipe I was going to take, and then falling face first into the armor.
Okay. Give me, for the hell of it, give me a strength or, give me an acrobatics check. Oh, no, shit. Athletics. Okay. So you go stumbling forward with such force that you actually manage to push the Skeleton King forward 5 feet.
As the Skeleton King is moving forward, I would like to use my reaction to duck down and tabletop him so he trips over me and falls prone.
Yes.
I'll allow it. I guess roll... That one's going to be acrobatic. Yeah, I'd say so.
Very nice.
Alright. We're playing chess now. Okay. Duck, go down to basically bend it over in half, and the Skeleton King is caught off balance and goes tumbling over you, and he takes a fall, at which point the Minotaur Skeleton takes a swipe at him as well with his great axe. And it whiffs. But it's well above your head, Adron. And after the axe misses, he writes it and you're able to stand up again.
Excellent, thank you.
So if he got an attack of opportunity, does Leo also get one?
No,
I am unconscious.
Leonis is unconscious. And that was Luke's turn, but...
Leonis is unconscious?
Yes.
Oh, crap.
Help.
Leonis got healed last week by the cleric, and then immediately took a hit right after that, after getting healed by the skeleton.
He's falling.
Swung through and hit Luke, and then swung through and hit Leonis. A quibble.
Oh, crap. I still lay on hands. Okay.
Quibble will move to here.
You hear off in the corner, "I can't heal anybody right now. I kind of got a skeleton in my face."
I'm unconscious, so I don't hear it.
You go blah.
Quirk is going to cast his Unseen Servant. And last time I had put the stone down on the ground. So Unseen Servant is going to pick it up.
Okay.
And am I able to see through the opening from where the switch to open and close it is?
Are you able to see through the switch itself?
No, like, if I'm standing there with my hand on the switch, can I see through the opening?
Yes.
Yes. Then that is what I would like to do.
Okay.
I just want to clarify, you're not pushing this switch yet, are you?
No, I'm not switching it. I'm just holding onto the switch and watching through to see if anything comes running my way, I'm going to close it. As long as it's not you guys.
Okay, good.
Yes. If that big thing out there comes running at me, I'm going to close the door.
Fair point. Usually if big skeleton monsters come at me too, I usually try to door in between me and them.
Alright, so that is his turn.
Alright, let's see. Skeleton 50.
You just said Ari.
Ari should be in there.
Oh, why did it... Ari.
Because I did the next actor, and then you did next actor.
Oh, and also, I wonder if it had something to do with her not being a client. No, because I hit next actor. That's why. Ari, you're up. You have a skeleton diagonally or north.
I'm seeing another picture.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to ask, where am I at hit points wise? Because I can't see that.
Second here. Are sitting at
16 right now.
20 HP. That's actually woo that you're seeing on us.
Yeah, no, I said that.
Okay.
Okay, that's not too bad. Okay, where's... I'm not able to get to Leonis, am I?
I don't believe so. You would be able to do it with a dash.
But then I wouldn't be able to use lay on hands when I got to him, right?
Yeah, you definitely couldn't get there just by running straight. Because you get difficult terrain and running through allies. But you've got this giant minotaur skeleton there as well. If you run one to the left, that would be 5 feet. Then up the same row as Leonis is 30 feet. Then another one over would be 35. Or, I'm sorry, 30. So 40 feet, basically.
What would happen if she were to take the corner here.
Oh yeah, and take the corner with Gregor.
Yeah.
Actually, if she took that corner, she'd be able to do it.
Oh, hold on.
What? I heard my name. What's going on?
We're trying to figure out a way for Ari to get to me.
I'm just imagining jumping over the half room.
Actually, she could get there in 25, technically, by cutting past Luke as well. I mean, that's not necessary, I'm just saying.
I'll duck. Ari can acrobatics jump over me. I'm like 3 feet tall.
Yeah, you can actually make it.
If I crouch, she can jump over me.
But it is 2 attacks of opportunity.
Unless the skeleton's not going to attack her.
Yeah, from God what we've seen,
it's going to be one attack of opportunity.
Yeah, I'll definitely take that.
The Minotaur is probably not going to attack you, though.
So. Yeah, no, I'll definitely take that. I look up and I see Leonis over there down, and I look at the rest of the group, and then I take off after him.
Okay, so the attack of opportunity incoming.
Okay.
15 to hit.
I believe that does not hit. Yeah, no, my armor class is 16.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So you see this skeleton, and you kind of poise yourself, looking back and forth. You see Leonis, and you're like, "F it, I'm gone." So tearing off around Stryker and around the rest of the party, the Minotaur skeleton is too involved with the skeleton and the shenanigans that just happened between Luke and Adron to even worry about you, and you're able to duck around beside Luke and get to Leonis.
Okay, so I'm gonna drop down onto my knees next to Leonis and place my hands on his back. I assume he's face down.
Well,
I don't know.
I have no idea what position I'm in. I got hit with a sword and then I died.
He probably is on his back.
Okay, I'm just gonna place my hands on his back and close my eyes and use the rest of my lay on hands. So that's 10 more points, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's I'm literally out of all spells, guys.
And sending abilities. You a new picture with updated RE movement.
Okay. Thank you.
I not stead.
Okay, yeah, so that's that's all I can do. That's the end of my turn.
Okay. And then skeleton 50. Seeing that its target left, it now takes an attack against Riker. Well, at least I'm consistent, mate. I think that's the third or fourth 11 on the die that I've rolled totals of 15 to hit.
Oh, am that I does... up, by the way?
You would be up, yes.
Okay.
17. Once you take your healing.
Yep.
You have 10 hit points.
Cool, thanks.
You're welcome.
So skeleton 50 striker swings at you with its short sword. And it misses. Leonis.
Hey, I'm up. If I were to try to... Well, I'm on my back right now. On my back, on my stomach.
It would be half of your movement back up. From being
and would
wrong.
I be in attack of opportunity range from...
From the Skeleton King, yes.
Except he's prone. He doesn't get one.
He is prone. I like
that's,
you.
That's
you're,
true.
You're
yep.
a cool person. Cool. I'm going to use half my movement to get up.
Okay.
Half my movement. Well, as I get up, I say, oh, thank you so much. And then... I waddle over half my movement. I have 15, so I'm going to waddle over into the corner.
Okay.
I just nod at him and get my knees as a reaction. Not my knees, my feet. I'm on my knees.
Okay, then... Yeah, because this needs to happen. I'm going to cast... I'm going to cast my last level 2 Moonbeam directly on... on Skeleton King.
Okay, make it happen.
Okay. It needs to make a saving throw.
Constitution save, is that right?
Yep. And also circle, is that control or is that shift?
Shift. No, control. Control.
Oh, I don't want to move it.
Yeah, you have to draw it first
no,
and then move it.
Where did that one come from? I can't control that one. There we go. Yeah, it's right on top of the Skeleton King, like covers up
okay.
pretty much his
yeah,
entire body.
I can
body.
See it. There's purple cool. surrounding him now. So let's see here. Find the Skeleton King. That's where it's here. Alright. And it's Constitution Saving Throw is what?
Its constitution saving throw is 14.
And does it still take half?
Yes.
Okay, well, it looks like since you used this before on the skeletons, it seems like you're not taking as much damage from it as what he would be. Natural 20 on his save.
Okay.
So, seems to be enjoying this moonlight. Go ahead and roll your damage, though.
Okay. Oh, that was a good roll!
Oh, nice! So 17 halved. Still going to be...
8 or 9, depending on rounding up or rounding down.
Alright. And is that everything, Jonas?
That is all I can do. That goes my guys.
Alright, Torin.
Should have combat advantage because of people being the other side of the guy.
Sweet. Well, seeing as the other Dragonborn is up and ran away, Torin instead is just going to use his mace and whack the skeleton.
That sounds like a grand idea.
Now if I can just figure out how to do this.
You have your player sheet up?
Do I just click where like the dice plus six is?
Yes. You'll have to double click it.
Well, that's shit.
That's a hit.
That's a hit, okay.
That's a hit.
It's a skeleton.
You should roll a second time to see if it's a crit, though.
Oh, yeah.
It is not.
It's okay. That damage was enough to actually kill this skeleton. So, let's... That was skeleton.
Is it starting to reform?
Actually, no.
Cool.
Okay, anything else, Torin?
I know I have bonus actions. Because I know... Fudge. I know I have bonus actions, but I'm not used to this because it doesn't show me, like, what's a bonus action and what's an action. Unless I actually look up the description of the spell.
I believe Healing Word is a bonus action. Just saying.
That is a bonus action.
It is a bonus action. Are you within 60 feet?
If you use right and mouse, left and right mouse buttons, you measurement, and Leonis is actually within 45 feet.
So that's 60 feet.
Okay, within 45, that works. Okay, Healing Word. 7 points.
Alright, so Leonis, get another 7.
Apparently I have 4 first level, 2, 3 second level, and 2 third spell level slots, so I could have used that as a higher one, but I also don't know how to do that either.
Basically you add whatever bonus it gives, and then on your sheet you're able to mark off which spell slot you use for it.
I mean, I'm going to use the first for now, but, like, when I want to use a second... So when you say for a second, I wouldn't just, like, click it twice and just be like, oh, that's a second level?
No, there's... you have to do a little bit of the calculation here with some of the spellcasting. It doesn't automatically add the bonus dice or anything like that.
Yeah, you just grab the dice that are in the row at the bottom, and you throw them onto the chat window.
Yeah.
Healing Word,
if you pick up a die and then you right click it, while still holding down your left button, that'll let you multiple dice.
So I would just do that and then add 3.
Right.
Okay.
You can also down in the lower left use modifier box.
Yes, I do.
You can click in that box and be modifier in. You've got your +2 and +5, which are some of your more common modifiers, but you can type in a custom one.
Oh, okay, that works.
Prior. So
that was just experimenting. He takes the 7.
Takes the 7. Alright.
And then that's my turn.
And that's your turn. All right. And next up is the skeleton.
I clicked it, and you clicked it. So Minotaur skeleton.
So Minotaur skeleton.
I think from now on we should just let the DM click it, so we stop skipping people.
Yeah, it probably would be better. Even though it would be nice if you guys would click it. But I've gotten into the habit of clicking a button that it's not really a big deal. Adron, you have an attack of opportunity against Minotaur Skeleton if you want it.
I am
Riker,
so...
You also have one against it.
I am so focused on the Skeleton King that I'm not facing the right direction for it, so...
Wait, where is he going?
It's moving closer towards the Skeleton King. It's moving away from you.
Wait, Skeleton King or against the Minotaur?
Attack of opportunity is against the Minotaur.
However, the Minotaur is going after the Skeleton King. Probably don't want to draw its attention until after that is taken care of.
I'm gonna... because I kind of moved at... Like, I let Ari pass earlier, I kind of am not paying attention, so I'm not gonna take it either.
Okay. Alright. So Minotaur Skeleton is still... I mean, it's crazy, because you can almost hear it breathing. You know, you can hear these huffs coming out of it. And it takes another swipe at the Skeleton King with this great axe.
With advantage, because the Skeleton King is still prone.
And even with advantage, this Minotaur Skeleton swings its axe up overhead and drops it down, and the Skeleton King kind of rolls out of the way. It brings it up again and swings it down, and it just the one swing, it swings up and over its head, and the Skeleton King is able to roll out of the way, and it lets out a huge bellow at the end. Now the Skeleton spends half of his movement to get up and begins attacking.
Constitution saving throw. Sorry.
Yeah, he's starting his turn.
I kept saying it, then I realized my mic was muted, and that was problematic.
Okay, roll damage.
Where did my level 2 spells go?
I ate them. Nom nom.
Good. That's problematic. I'm going to just roll 2d10. Because for some reason is not there, and I'll fix that. 10.
The average.
Yeah. Also.
Okay. So you can see that the moonbeam like starting to sizzle on the skeleton bone. And everything. And he growls and gets out of the way of the moonbeam and then makes an attack against the Minotaur skeleton, swinging his sword in a vicious slash horizontally from left right.
Also, I figured out why it wasn't there, and that's because when you use up all your spell slots, all your spells in that level go away.
That was an attack against you, but it's because I had the wrong person targeted, so ignore that was a hit.
Cool. I like not being hit.
It is a terrible idea that they would do that, because you can cast anything in a higher level slot.
What was that?
I completely agree, Alex. Like, that's a really terrible idea, because I can't, even if it's a continuous thing, even though I technically cast my third spell, it goes away, too. So I'm just going to say that I have one left so I can see it.
Does it go away, or does it minimize? Because a lot of the things...
It completely goes away.
Yeah, that sucks.
Like, as far as I can scroll down, it's level 1 Thunder Wave, which is problematic. Oh, if I move the modes from combat standard, they show back up again.
That's because combat may be taking into effect what spell levels you've already cast.
That's weird. Okay.
Okay,
go
so
stay
let's
in
see
standard
here.
Then.
Minotaur skeleton. That hit. Yes, that hits. All right. Oh. And it looks like this attack by the Skeleton King was superficial to the Minotaur Skeleton. The Minotaur Skeleton's able to parry a little bit of the blow, blade glances off of the Minotaur skeleton's shoulder, and it growls right back. Oh, I already. So, next up is a drawn.
Just one question. Did guy actually move there, or was that just an accidental move?
Did what?
The Hemelkid Horror, did he actually move to there, or was that just
accidental? Yes, he moved to there.
Okay. Shouldn't Adron have gotten an attack of opportunity on that?
No, because I had already used my reaction for that round.
Yes, he should have. Sorry.
No, because I... Oh, you guys can't hear me. Hold on. The answer there is actually no, because I had already used my reaction for that round. I used my reaction to trip him, which does not allow me to take a reaction of attack of opportunity.
Okay.
So.
Yeah. All right. So there was a reason I didn't say that, but okay. Anyway, so you moved to there.
So yeah, I'm moving around the moonbeam. I go over, and since the Skeletor...
Chat says... Sorry, guys. Chat says, R2, may I suggest a new strategy? Let the undead Minotaur win.
So seeing that the Skeletor and the Skeleton King are facing each other, I come up to the side of the Skeleton King, run up his side, grab him by the skull, and rip his head off in order to slam the skull into the ground and shatter it.
Okay, that sounds like fun. Let's do an acrobatics for the running up the side, and then let's do a strength check for the ripping off of the head. Okay.
Rolling great tonight, guys. Doing great.
We can. And actually, shouldn't that have been an unarmed attack?
Technically, it is an unarmed attack. What?
Because
what
I have bonuses. I have proficiency in unarmed attacks.
That's going to give you another 14.
Yeah, that'll take me to 14, yeah.
Is that a total of 14, Adron?
Dang it, I keep forgetting to switch over. The people at home can hear me because I have the mic open for OBS, but... but yeah, that would be a total of 14.
Total of 14, okay. So, I will keep that in mind while I do. Alright, so you go running up the side of this thing. Its arm is out after just completing the swing of its sword. You're able to use its sword for leverage. You pull the head off of the thing and throw it down to the ground. Roll 6 damage.
I'm sorry, they roll a what damage?
D6.
Yeah, you've been cutting in and out sometimes.
Come okay, on. I don't know what's going on. That sucks.
I just blame TeamSpeak.
Do I get my strength bonus with that at least?
No.
Do I get my strength bonus with that at least? Because that'll take it to a 3.
Rolling so well tonight, guys.
Yes.
Hey, it's a mini helmet horror.
That's the head. Leonis, if you would be so kind to take a picture of that so that those that are not in Fantasy Grounds can see my brilliance. That was 3 damage?
Yes, with my strength bonus.
With the bumper, yes.
Okay.
Looks so cool, does almost nothing.
Alright. So, I mean, you can tell that with the addition of Natar Skeleton joining this fray, you guys are standing a lot better chance against it than you did without its help. The skeleton being, though, doesn't seem really affected by the fact that its head has now been ripped off of its shoulders.
And spiked like a football.
And spiked like a football. Are you still hanging on to his shoulders, or what are you doing after that point, Adron?
I'm going to use my remaining 20 feet of movement.
Okay.
And although it'll be for no damage, can I use my bonus action to kick the head, you know, farther away from the body?
Yes. And give me an athletics plus a proficiency, I guess.
Okay, and it'll be in the direction of the line I drew.
Okay, that's fine. Alright, so wow. You actually managed to kick it. We're right up next to him, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
But yeah, you kick it another, like, 15 feet away, because your foot kind of glanced off of it, but you did still manage to get enough of a connection that you could send it skittering along a little ways at least. Alright, and next up is Stryker. You have a skeleton all up in your face. Oh, and I just realized I don't have music going.
I forgot about that guy. Okay, I'm going to use my bonus action to disengage, take,
okay,
and then go back 10 feet, like,
back towards
to
the wall,
left of the map, 10 feet away, then attack the skeleton.
Okay, with your short bow.
Okay, so I rolled an 11 to hit the skeleton.
That does not hit.
And then I'm going to go... I'm going to go 15 feet... I guess up. Just straight up. Or no, I'll go 15... towards Luke.
15 feet towards Luke? I mean, if you go 15 feet straight up, you are right in front of the passageway, the secret passage.
Yes. That passageway thingy. Yep.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, you're right in front there. Turn. Okay. Luke. All right, so I'll go ahead and make those attacks for you. Alright, so Luke is attacking Skeleton.
I didn't hear Luke at all.
It was a message in Skype.
Ah, okay.
So it's a good thing you didn't hear Luke. If you did, that would have been weird.
It's... that... Okay, and I will give Luke movement if he does it at the end of the round, because I don't know if he wants to move anywhere or not. He just said attacking the skeleton. So next up is, actually that's the top of the round. So, Quibble. Are you muted?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Alright. So, Quibble will take the disengage.
Alright.
And will come and pick up the skull.
Okay.
And then still got another 5 feet.
As soon as Quibble picks up the skull, Quirk, here in your, you know, through your telepathic connection and everything, with Quibble, you hear, "What are you doing? Put me down! We'll suffer mortals!"
Cool. Going that way.
Cool. Great. Good job. I enjoyed that. That's lovely to hear. How's your day going?
Okay, and Quirk.
All right. Okay. So he's gonna kind of go into the... So, is it 5 feet or 10 feet wide?
It's 10 feet wide, 10 feet long.
Okay. Just gonna come through to there, and... So, are there issues with line of sight on this guy, or is the fact that he's a large creature mean that I can just shoot at his head?
He is on the ground, I think.
No, he's up.
Skeleton King is actually standing. Okay. He is about 10 feet tall, though.
You know what? I'll go up 5 feet so I'm above everyone and just take a clean shot over.
That's fine.
Okay, so I need to target him. And I will Ray of Frost.
Which misses.
Alright.
Quirk is targeting Quirk the way. Just...
Ah?
That attack still would have missed.
Oh, I know. I just... something... That's, you probably shouldn't attack yourself.
I do not understand why. Okay.
All I know...
So then... that was 20 feet, so... I still have enough to come back here and put my hand on the switch again.
Alright.
Kalia, you said he was 10 foot tall, but I think he's a head shorter than that.
Yeah.
Yeah. 9 and some change. And that brings us to Ari.
I enjoyed that. Thank you.
Okay, so I can get up and around the moonbeam and down just right next to the Skeleton King, right? If I'm counting that correctly.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, so I want to move to that spot that I can get to right up next to him, and I'm going to take a swing at him with my Sword of Logical Doom.
Go ahead.
Sorry for those of you at home, I had to cough.
That's going to be a 16. Oh. Yeah, 16. Plus my modifier. Is that... Do I add my strength when I... Plus?
Your attack bonus includes your strength already.
Yeah, okay. So... What exactly is my attack bonus? I'm used to it always being
okay, added. Okay, let me pull up your sheet real quick here, Ari. Hold on.
If you have a strength modifier of +1, and then you have a proficiency of +2, it should be +3.
And then I also get a +1 on my sword, so +4.
Yep.
Okay, so then that's going to be 20.
That exactly hits.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, I'm seeing your Sword of Logical Doom as a +4 attack bonus. So.
Yeah. And then that's a D1D8?
It's D8 for the weapon, and then a D... actually, no, you're not getting the, not getting
yeah,
the...
just missed
the Hail of
one.
Thorns this time.
Yeah, so that's gonna be then plus just 1 for my strength. 5
damage.
Slowly hacking away at him.
How do you want to do this?
Seriously?
Seriously, how do you want to do this?
Oh my god, okay. Give me a second to think.
Damn, I was going to use a third level guiding bolt on the bastard, but good job.
Well, there's still
DM. I'm not completely evil.
There's still the Skeletor to deal with too.
If it attacks us.
And skeleton 50.
Well, yes, there's always that.
Okay, I want to I'm just going to I turn and I sprint around the moonbeam and I jump at the last second and drive my sword into that hole where its head is in its armor, and I just want to like cut it in half.
Damn. That sounds cool. I like it. So, yeah, that's what happens. And you see both sides of the armor just, like, peel apart. Everybody in the party, you lose sight of Ari for a second while she goes diving inside the armor. And she charges down. There was a game that I used to play a long time ago called Rastan, and he could jump, and then he would drive his sword down into the ground. And that's kind of what Ari does. She jumps up and goes diving in through his suit of armor, and you hear the clattering of bones as her sword just goes directly down through him, and in a split second later, pun intended, a split second later, his armor comes open, and you see Ari down kind of on one knee, looking around, breathing a little bit heavily. She's kind of miffed.
Just a little bit.
Alright.
Yeah. That's my turn.
That's your turn. Skeleton 50 takes a swipe at the Minotaur skeleton. And he misses horribly. He's not even anywhere close to hitting that thing. And Leonis.
Okay. Quick, I want to make a perception check on the Minotaur skeleton. Is it Exactly like the one, not physically, but more like the way that it's moving, the huffing that we hear. Is it exactly like one that we faced before? I want to see what I can discern from that.
Yeah, it actually is. I'm not going to make you roll it. It is.
Okay. Can I get any? I wouldn't know why it's thinking. Okay. Everybody's in the way of my moonbeam. Okay, so I'm going to run over to Luke, and I'm going to cast a Cure Wounds on him.
Okay.
Gonna untarget Helmtor.
Yeah, the last thing you want is to bring this thing back to unlife after you killed it.
I can't untarget it for some reason.
Okay, combat tracker's being weird here lately, and I don't know what's going on.
It was being weird last week. All I do is I right-click on me.
There.
Click on me, and then just, like, drag it.
Okay, it looks like you got Luke now, so...
Yep. Healing Luke. Yeah! I'm rolling decently well tonight. And he's 12 hit points. That's good. And it automatically did it, too.
Who did you heal? Yourself?
Luke.
Ah.
Hey. Anything else?
Also, where is Luke?
TeamSpeak died.
Okay. Hopefully TeamSpeak undies.
Working on coming back in.
Cool.
Is going to be Torin.
Can I stand on the pedestal?
Dan.
Sweet.
Yeah, it's like there's a dais on the floor that raises up maybe about 2 feet, and then there's the pedestal directly in the center.
Yeah, I want to stand on the pedestal.
Okay. Pedestal goes up. Yeah, the pedestal goes up. Oops. Could lock those two together. Pedestal goes up a couple of feet, but you're able to climb up it without much incident.
Sweet. I'm gonna, just for shits and giggles, I'm gonna do the same thing I was gonna do to the big guy. Third level guiding bolt on skeleton 50.
Alright.
Alright, I'll
Holy crap.
Roll to attack first, correct?
Yeah, and you can actually target him by control clicking him. Okay, one. I see it.
Okay, I click cast, correct?
It should be, you have it set for combat right now?
Yeah, I see cast and attack.
So let me pull up your character sheet and I can see exactly what you're looking at right now. Oh, doesn't show it that way for me. Combat. You're doing Guiding Bolt, you said?
Yeah.
So yeah, you'll click the cast.
Wow.
Send a bolt of crackling golden energy out at the out at skeleton 50 there, and because you're a little bit unsteady on this pedestal, your attack misses high and wide. The skeleton 50 turns as the bolt goes past it.
All right, then.
And with that, Minotaur Skeleton turns around and swings his great axe. hitting skeleton 50 square in the chest. Sending its bones just scattering all over the floor.
I just thought of something. Sorry, this is just completely random. Do they have the breath weapons in this?
Yes, I believe they do.
Yes, they do.
It's weird. You have to kind of put it in weirdly. Mine is under powers. I can help you with that later if you want.
Okay.
I haven't actually used my breath weapon yet to do that.
Okay, there's a lot of stuff you guys haven't used yet that I've given you. Okay, so yeah, the bones of Skeleton 50 just go scattering across the wall. Several of you have to duck as bones go flying past your head and everything, but you're able to dodge out of the way without incident. The Minotaur Skeleton, after being Skeleton King and his cronies dispatched, returns back this way.
Does he acknowledge us at all?
Nope.
Just walks back with his axe dragging again?
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, so, just real quick, Adron steps over to Ari, gives her a quick kiss on the cheek, and then dashes over to Stryker.
Did I see that?
I get rid of Moonbeam.
Ari, did I see that?
Probably.
I wasn't trying to hide it.
Much in the way.
Ari. Okay. Just turns bright red. I mean, completely blushes and lets go of her sword and is just kind of standing there trying to just trying
about
to.
Like that, Ari.
Oh my god, you turned all of our things red. I don't like it, turn it back, please. I was not ready for that, it was really confused.
We're all dead now.
No, just...
I come back and everything's changed. Oh god, what's happening?
I healed you, that's what's happening. You're now not dying. Also, it's purple, what?
You guys are in a dungeon. It makes sense for it to be purple.
Cool. When that happens,
I've got mood
I'm
lighting
going
powers as a DM.
Quickly yell to Quirk. Quirk, do you have the stone?
Got an echo.
Yeah, I got it!
Okay, bring it in here.
The echo's from, Annika last time I knew.
Yeah, I just fixed it.
Okay. So, I come in and I bring my... unseen servant with me.
Do I see the unseen servant? Doubt it.
Probably don't see it.
So,
well, my question is, do I see like a floating stone, or are you carrying the stone?
That you just see the stone floating after me.
Quirk, why is the stone floating?
Because it's my unseen servant holding it. Because it has creepy voices, and I didn't want to listen to them.
That makes.
To be fair, Quirk, you wouldn't have known about the creepy voices. That was an Adron thing.
Oh. Okay, I thought I heard them when I picked it up, too.
No, it was Adron because he was trying to force the skeletons back inside the stone.
Okay, then...
Touched part of the stone, basically.
Retcon the voices instead, I say. It flashed big and brought something through an interdimensional vortex. I figured I shouldn't hold on to it.
Of interdimensional vortex, and I look over at the blue dragonborn that's standing on a pedestal right now. Where did you come from?
That's a good question. I'm still not entirely sure myself.
I start walking over to him.
Torin hops down from the pedestal.
I'm going to make a medicine check as I'm checking over Stryker for wounds and such. Trying to bind any that are apparent.
Okay.
Quibble brings the skull over to Adron.
I'm fine. Just really done with this dungeon.
Ari's going to just pick back up her sword, take a second to compose herself, and then she's going to rejoin a Drawn and Striker and everybody over there.
Just say one more time for me, please, Ari.
Oh, I just, Ari takes a second to, like, compose herself, and she picks back up her sword and, then rejoins Adron and Striker and everybody over there, kind of, you know, regrouping.
Okay.
When I get the skull from Quibble, I'm just going to smash it against the wall. And then the broken pieces at the floor, I'm going to stomp into dust.
All right. You can definitely that hold on, I just got a message from Brandon here. You notice that the life stone, there was a halo kind of surrounding this thing with like a white-ish light that has dimmed considerably now that you dealt with the Skeleton King.
I do believe our first order of business should be getting somewhere we can fortify and resting up.
I agree. I am hurting lots.
Torin, hearing this, jumps right into action. He walks over to Quark and casts a third level Cure Wounds on him.
Roll it up.
You heal 17 points of hit points.
Yay! Thank you! Gives you a big hug.
You're kind of just like taken aback and then just... What is Quark?
An Aarakocra.
I have no idea what that is.
He's giant bird man.
He's like a humanoid bird. But he looks like a phoenix. His coloration gives him the pattern of like a phoenix. Yellows and oranges and
how
reds.
How tall is he?
5 foot?
Okay, they're about the same height then. Look, Torin's a little taller, but... You know, Torin just kind of pats his head and says, it's alright. I need to figure out where I'm at anyway. I might as well help out.
Yeah, I got pulled through in a thing like that too.
So what exactly was going on here? I mean, I'm walking in town and then portal, my god told me to go through and I went through and I was here. It all kind of happened really fast.
Yeah, so what happened is that
we'll probably
stones...
Quark is a long story. We should probably get out of here first and then we'll deal with where we are and all that. At least get somewhere defensible.
I second that again. We need to get out of here.
We should at least know his name.
My name is Torin Rixius.
Hello, I am Leonis. Funny name you have there. My last name is Torin as well.
I am
that is rather Torin. Interesting.
I am a drone, and at that point, I put Stryker back on my shoulders. Put a hand on Ari's shoulder, make sure she's okay as well, and then head through the secret passage.
Luke,
do I hit my head
in a wave?
I'm on Adron's shoulder, just going through the passage. Should I duck?
No, you've got plenty of space.
Ari, she sheathes her sword at this point and nods and says, "My name is Ariadne." She nods and then heads after Adron and Stryker through the secret passage.
I'm just like, I'm Quirk, and this is Quibble, and yeah, I'll explain everything.
Alright, sure.
Oh, Quirk.
I mean, I'm gonna follow you guys out, because I don't even know. I got in here a little weird. I'm sure you guys know a way out.
We may know a way out, but that doesn't mean we know where we're going right now.
Okay, I'm going to remove Helmed Horror head for ease of you.
I smashed its head.
Didn't we smash it anyway?
Yeah, well, GG, I just deleted guys. All of the tokens off of the map.
We're all dead. Good game.
Congratulations, the world just ended.
Reality has stopped. That's okay.
Who dropped the probability grenade?
That's okay. I'm not super worried about it. You guys, are you stopping here for right now, or are you making your way back out of the dungeon?
Can we just get out of here, please?
Yeah, I think we should try and find our way out before we stop. I don't want to have that Minotaur turn around and decide we're not his friends anymore.
We've done everything that we needed to here. I assume this is the stone that you guys were looking
for. I believe we are done here. Let us exit the temple as soon as possible.
You guys mind if I carry the stone?
Well, my unseen servant still has it.
I know, but it has it slow.
Who is it that was asking?
Me? Leonis.
Yeah, I'm okay with Leonis carrying it.
Thanks.
So we're all agreed we're put out?
Yeah, I think it's time to leave.
I believe the common phrase is, let's get the fuck out of here.
Get the hell out of here.
Alright, so, let's see here. Go ahead and I'm going to pull up the party sheet.
Also, Quark, did you give me the stone or did you want to...
If you want, you can just kind of grab it from the unseen servant. It's not going to keep it from
me. I asked the party as a question, but I'm more looking towards Quark right now because unseen servant has stone.
Yeah, I'm just going to be like, sure, if you want it.
Okay, I feel more safe in my own hands over an unseen servant.
Okay.
Okay, and I grab the stone.
All right.
How big is this stone?
It's about a foot long, and probably about 2 to 3 inches around.
Is it a perfect cylinder? Is it jagged? Like
no, let me. I've got a picture here somewhere.
I see two lifestone. Their lifestone.
It is the life. Take a look at the fire lifestone.
And just imagine that, but not that
but it's
color.
Black. It's pure black.
Okay, cool.
trying to award you guys experience right now. And it looks like, even with those two encounters, it says that you didn't level up. But that's bullshit. Level. Level to 5. And with that, I think we're going to take a quick break, guys, so that we can get you leveled up real quick. And we're also going to come back to the Critters Community actual channel proper, because I've got the stream key now. So.
Okay, so there will be a short blackout as I get that switched over.
All right, and we're welcome back, everybody, from our short little break there. We got the party mostly leveled real quick. And so, guys, find your way out of the temple without problem. You notice that the sun is starting to set once you exit the temple. And
once Luke is out of the temple, he just lies flat on his back and just stares up at the sky.
Are you okay there?
How's the fire doing that we had? How's the fire doing that we had set outside the temple?
This island is charred black.
Good place to be laying, Luke.
I don't even care.
Are there any frog's legs cooked in the charcoal?
No.
Unless you like them burnt, in which case, have at it.
Well,
I mean, they have been consumed by the fire. This fire has been going for like 2 days now.
Okay.
Because control wind only lasted for 10 minutes.
I thought it was an hour.
Either way, it's gone by now.
Yeah,
it's well and truly gone. And nobody is mourning its loss. So Luke, you lay down on the ground, and you can still feel the heat from the fire.
Luke literally couldn't give a damn.
Okay. What is everybody else doing?
I'm looking now at Luke. What?
Now that we're outside, I go ahead and put Striker down.
I'm gonna stop and do a bit of a medicine check on myself and try and patch up some cuts and bruises I have on myself.
Yeah, I go to assist.
Okay.
I consider stepping in between them, and then I decide not to and go find the nearest tree and climb.
There are no trees, Breaker.
You can climb there the pile no of charcoal. Listen,
everything
fire swamp has been burnt to the ground. You have Quirk to thank for that.
I got an 18 on my medicine check, by the way.
Okay. Yeah, I think you only need.
Does the temple have a roof, a ceiling, something higher ground?
Yeah. Okay. So you recall from I'm pulling up the swamp map high level again. It hasn't been updated to show the burning devastation that's happened to it, but the roof was angled, Striker, and there were some columns at the front of the building as you were entering, that you probably could use to climb to get up on top of the building.
So Striker has a very strong need to climb something.
Okay. Go ahead
so
and
I will
roll
climb this.
Go ahead and roll your
anything?
Athletics.
I rolled a 19. Finally, a good athletics roll.
Alright, nice. So you go scrambling. You guys notice... Are you doing this stealthily, or are you just, like, as soon as you get outside, you're bounding up it?
As soon as Adron puts me down, I'm climbing up. I don't even care who sees.
Okay. So you just go bounding up this column, very monkey-esque, as you go climbing up the column, shimmy along the front ledge a little bit, pull yourself up, and like tumble up onto the top of the roof. It is slanted a fair amount, but you're able to get your grip and get yourself anchored in pretty good on top of the roof.
Who was that?
That was probably Anne.
It was Annika.
Oh, okay.
For once, it wasn't Anne timing out.
Good. Okay. So Ari and Adron, see, you were just assisting her, right, Adron?
Well, I was assisting her or, you know, getting injuries that she couldn't reach, that sort of thing.
Okay.
That's why I went ahead and did a full roll.
Okay. So, yeah, I mean, you're able to assist her. I don't believe the medicine kit actually allows you to heal wounds.
It stabilizes.
So,
stops her from bleeding, that sort of thing.
Right. So, I mean, it's more for flavor than anything.
Yeah, I just...
In this particular instance, anyway.
Yeah.
Alright, so the sun is starting to set on this island. And you guys have a little bit more sense of than while you were in the dungeon, but not much more.
You guys think it's worth it to camp here, or should we go to the mainland?
There were bullywugs here last time, and although much has been burned, I do believe they may want their island back. I say we go somewhere a little bit safer than this.
That's fine with me. Let's go back to... What town did you come from?
Almraven.
How far away is Almraven from us right now?
I don't know. I was never there.
I suspect that we will have to be camping out here in the swamp tonight. I suggest doing so in a tree.
There are no trees left.
Going to the mainland.
Well,
we're
I...
on an island right
it, it was... It's just the island that burned.
Yes. Right.
So
right,
if we... If,
the island that burned.
Yeah, if we swim across to the little lake, there are trees over there.
Oh, I thought he was talking about a tree on the island.
No.
We're getting off the island.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Let's go.
Okay, guys. Real quick, because I forgot about this before we took our break. I just put into the party sheet for right-hand corner icon.
Oh,
and
that's top
you look at your inventory,
right.
That is the loot from the dungeon.
I'm not on the party sheet.
Oh, let me fix that. I can fix
all the parcel items?
Yes.
And we don't know what the unidentified items were.
Correct.
Hey, Quirk.
Be on the party sheet now, Torin.
Yay.
Yeah, I can identify all those things.
Let's do that once we get to our campsite. We want to make sure that we are safe before we do anything.
Okay. Would that amber there happen to be in the shape of a rod?
It's a stone.
Speaking of inventory, that's something else I have to do for Torin. I just hope Roll 20 will cooperate so I can actually get down what he had.
Okay, let us go then.
It's a small stone quirk.
Okay.
Did we have to swim before to get onto the island?
Yes.
Yep.
I did not realize that.
This is gonna be fun.
So what?
Oh, don't worry, I'm helping Ari across.
That's great, but I'm in heavy armor.
So am I. I'll sink to the bottom.
If you're trying to get off, hey, hold Kirk. On. I can help you here. If you look...
Phrasing!
Thanks, Diggity. So are you kind of like looking at the water right now, or what?
Torin?
Yeah.
Torin was just kind of following everybody. If everybody just takes off, he just kind of stands there and like, heavy armor, water, don't really mix well.
I could help you guys across if you want.
I can help as well.
How do you guys plan on doing that?
I'll just put up a floating disc and you can sit on it, and then when I fly across it will follow me.
How much weight can that floating disc carry? Because I'm also in very, very heavy armor.
Up to 100 pounds, I believe.
So I'm more than
500 pounds.
500 pounds.
I'm not more than 500 pounds.
Well, you have to add up how many people it's going to have to take over.
I mean, he could do multiple trips as well.
I can fly over and back.
I feel like there's a riddle here somewhere.
So, seeing that Ari is going to be taking the floating disc over, I hold my hand out for Stryker.
Stryker is up on the roof.
I just climb up, and I don't take his hand, I just climb up.
So you're just on top of the temple?
Well, no,
well, no, I went down as soon as people were talking about women. Sorry. I probably shouldn't have said that. I was like, nope. Just kind of walk past everyone, climbing on the disc, whatever the plan is.
I'm swimming across.
I jump in the water to wash off, the remains of the temple. Swim across as well.
Oh yeah, man, they're all gonna get a bath.
Yep. Baths are nice.
If you two are good, then I'm going to go across.
If you don't have a swim speed, how fast can you swim?
It's half movement.
Like, how does the swimming without a swim speed work?
It's considered difficult terrain, so half movement.
I start swimming across.
Stryker just jumps in the water and starts swimming.
Luke follows.
I stay pretty close to Stryker as we're swimming.
You guys get to the other side uneventfully. And you're able... Luke, you of course were their guide into... out of Almraven and into the swamp, and now it seems like you're their guide again to get back to Almraven, unless you guys are just sleeping here. And I think you could that you were just gonna climb up into some trees here and...
Yeah. Climbing into trees and sleeping is a good idea.
Torin is not okay with climbing trees in heavy armor. He will sit at the base of the tree and like lean against it.
You can just hop on the disc and come up.
I would rather have my feet on the ground, if that's okay with you.
Okay.
I'll stay down there with him.
And I'll stay down on the ground as well.
Despite the fact that I
Oh. Alright, the sun is now set beneath the trees. starting to get really dark. When you guys first came in this area, there were fires lit by the Bullywug camps and such, but you don't see those any longer. This place is pretty much a ghost town now.
I cast my cantrip Produce Flame in my hand, and I hold it up to get as much light as we can.
Oh, that's a good idea. Torin takes his mace and kind of like puts the handle into the ground and then casts light on it.
Okay.
Are we at a camp spot right now or no?
I mean, if you guys are creating a camp spot, then yeah. I mean, you.
How far away from this island do we want to get?
You guys are heading in this direction. Back towards Almraven.
I mean, you said that there weren't any signs of the Bullywugs, right? I mean, if it's been 2 days, you would think that they would have come back sooner if they were going to come back.
Right. No signs of the Bullywugs that you could...
I still say we should probably get a little bit further away from this place, if only to get away. Even if they do come back, there's a chance they could come back to take that risk.
How long will it take us to get back to Almraven?
Let me take a look at the map again. Yeah, you guys can pull up the map of Faerun Large. Like...
That is a map and a half. Holy crap.
Yeah, it is. Beautiful.
So many lines and dotted lines, and it's all so confusing.
We're down south, southeast. Near the first forest of Myr, to the west of Almar Mountains and below the Marching Mountains, we have the Spider Swamp, which is where...
Ah, okay, I see the blue line.
Almraven is where we want to go. I think that's actually where I think I came from there.
No, you were further north.
I came through the Forest of Myr.
You were in Cormanthor. The Dale Lands. You were up top here. Jonas.
No, as I was, like, how I got into the Spider Swamp.
Yeah, you would have come in through the Forest of Myr.
Okay, cool. Thank you. I just wanted to know which way, if I would have gone to Almraven yet or not.
Yeah, I mean, it's about 30 miles from Almraven to the Spider Swamp.
I say that we camp here and then we travel tomorrow.
Agreed.
If this place is as far as you say.
I agree.
Yeah, I agree with that as well. I'm pretty tired.
But let's find some trees... take our own watches, and then we should be able to get through the night and head back to civilization.
I can also put up an alarm.
Well, Torin points out that he's pretty much wide awake since he didn't really do anything, so he'll take the first watch as long as people need to.
Whatever works. Let's get our campsite ready first.
If everyone's willing to stay in kind of a 20-foot area, I can just put an alarm up and then be good if anyone comes. It'll wake us all up.
Just make sure that those of us who may need to step away to relieve ourselves do not set off the alarm when we come back.
Oh yeah, I can do that. That's no issue.
Also, when we get... I'm guessing we're back on the mainland now and off the island.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you guys are probably, like, right here-ish.
I call for Arya, by the way. As soon as we get back on the mainland.
Ah, Yes. You hear the rustling of something in the bushes, and when you call her name, you see a head up from out of the bushes, and then she comes bounding towards you.
There you are! And I pick her up and I put her on my shoulder.
Yeah, she
thank
like
you so much.
Comes leaping at your chest.
I grab her and I tell her and I pet her. There you are.
Her machine happens.
Who's your friend?
This is Aria. She's my companion, my cat companion. Been with me for a while now. I couldn't take her into that dungeon. Who knows what would have happened, but she knows how to survive on her own out in the wilderness, so I let her go. She always stays with me.
Is Leonis a ranger?
No, this is...
He's a druid.
I'm a druid, but this is all for role-playing purposes. I'm, based on my character's background.
Oh, okay.
Like, Arya does not fight in battle like a Quibble does.
Oh, okay.
She's just adorable.
Oh my god, Quirk, why? Quirk, why you do this?
Okay, so as soon as the camp is finished setting up, you know, I've made the mental note that I probably need to talk to Stryker, you know, in the near future. But the more I feel pressing conversation that needs to happen would be with Ari, so, you know, I pull her off to the side.
Okay.
Love that.
I have a question. Is there a tree nearby?
Yeah, you've got a lot of trees now near you.
Okay, but when he pulls her aside, can I stealthily try to, like, eavesdrop again?
Of course.
Because we all know how well the last time went.
Okay, so here's what I'm going to have you do. Roll your stealth, Ari and Adron, roll your perception in the tower.
All right, guys. All good.
You said perception?
Yeah.
Do you want me to,
You can whisper it to me.
Do you want me to, send this to you privately?
Yeah, Ari will have to do the same as well.
Adron and Ari, go.
Before...
So, Ari, you know, follows after Adron, and finally once he stops and they're at a distance away, she turns to him and says, yes?
I heard what Quibble had to say to you while we were in the temple. Wanted to make sure first that you were okay.
You mean about
I'm pretty
my,
sure he meant Quirk.
That's what I said.
You said Quibble.
I meant Quirk. Sorry.
I got it. Talking to birds. I assume you mean about my being a hypocrite. Yes, I'm yes, I'm fine. It's not the first time we've been called such things.
Well, one thing that I noticed as I was looking through, and I actually pull out the book soggy though it may be at this point.
Arya just smiles at the fact that he still has her book. She assumes pretty much no one else in the group still has it.
Looking through the book, it does not directly mention anything about arcane magic being wrong, and I cannot help but wonder where such a belief would come from.
That would be because the General Church of St. Cuthbert doesn't exactly agree with the beliefs of the order I'm a part of. I'm part of an order called the Rosy Cross of Truth that... it's complicated to explain, but basically my order does not believe in the use of arcane magic.
One would then have to wonder if perhaps someone within the order was pushing their own agenda. I mean no disrespect, but by the same token, it was, the world was made according to a certain logic. Ergo, arcane magic is a part of that logic, and to ignore logic, no matter what portion of it, is to lie to oneself and to be illogical. So,
Arya, you should not. Arya at this point just puts up her hand to stop him and looks up at him and. Look, Adron, I respect you. But these are life decisions I've made, and I can't explain to you why exactly I believe these things, or why my order believes these things. These are things that, unless you're a part of our church, unless you've been indoctrinated, I simply can't tell you some of the things that we know and that we believe.
I do not mean to make you uncomfortable. I am simply seeking to understand and to learn. It brings me pain to see someone so beautiful deny a part of themselves.
Arya, at that point, just looks him dead in the eyes and just look. I've personally seen the things that arcane magic does to people. The form it can twist people into, and I have my personal reasons for not agreeing or trusting its nature. Thank you for your compliment. But, and she breaks eyes contact with him and goes to turn away from him.
I put a hand on her shoulder before she walks away. I will not bring it up again unless you wish to discuss it. Just know that I am here for you and I will support whatever decision you choose. And I slowly remove my hand and let her walk away if she chooses to.
Ari's just gonna stand there for a moment and then she just kind of looks back over her shoulder and smiles a little bit and says, thank you, I note your support. And she looks like she's going to say something else for a moment, and then she closes her mouth and nods a little bit and turns and walks away.
Stryker, you heard every word of that.
Of course she has. Yes.
This is happening, I'm also going to turn to everybody whenever they're down.
Everybody in the camp, you may or may not realize that Stryker is missing.
Well, I'm going to look at. I know they go off. As soon when they do, I'm going to see. I'm just going to talk to the people who are currently in the camp. So if I don't see Stryker, then I'm going to assume he's not here.
Torin notices nothing. Because he doesn't know anybody.
Also, they're not here to get the stuff. Oh, money.
Holy crap!
That's a lot of money.
Wow.
How much money did you give us?
That was a lot. There was a lot of treasure to be had on those two floors.
Only in the rooms that we went to?
Yeah.
Oh, what else did we... Okay, anyway.
Wow, we have 54 platinum pieces?
Wait, we have what?
That's what the party coin thing says.
I cannot see that right now.
That's roughly... platinum's roughly 10 gold? Is that what it is?
Yep.
Still, that's a lot. That's 5,000.
Oh yeah,
that's 5,400 gold each.
Just so Anne and
No, 540.
Yeah, 540. Sorry.
Just so Ari and Stryker know, the money we got was 457 copper, 3,143 silver, 54 platinum, and 1,200 gold each.
Each?
Each.
Each. Oh,
did you math that properly, kid?
I did.
Oh my god. Balls. Okay.
That even went to Torin, who did almost nothing.
I'll fucking take it!
Honestly, I'll
Torin's going shopping. That up,
and I'll be like, here you go. Anyway, when they...
Torin stands up, says, fuck y'all bitches, and walks away.
You actually, or...
Shopping montage!
Okay.
I'll cut you. Yeah. Ari's just gonna cry as she donates all of that to her church.
Okay, before... I'm going to start talking as soon as they go away, by the way.
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay, so I see them walk off, and I turn to... I turn to the whole party and I'm like, well, we got a lot of stuff from that horrid place. Quirk, do you think you could identify everything that's in here?
Yeah.
Okay, and then I give all the stuff that we don't know what it is to him, and that's when he identifies it.
Okay, and I...
I'm gonna interrupt to an epiphany. That in the map, if I hold down the middle mouse button, actually moves the map around.
Yep.
I'm proud of myself for finding. Yeah.
It does.
You can use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out, and then if you want to move the map around, you can just hold down the middle mouse button and it moves it.
I didn't know about the middle.
You can also move your character with the middle mouse button as well. Like if you middle mouse click on your character and then drag, it'll set your movement.
Just made this whole interface a lot easier to use.
Anyway, so... Sorry, Adron.
No, I was just going to say, when I get back, I immediately look around for Stryker.
Okay, I think I'm still talking.
So, go ahead.
Not to cut you off, I think that you two are still talking, and then I'm talking to them.
Yeah, so,
sounds fair.
When I put all of this stuff in here, I thought that I had more with it. Thought that there were a few low-level magical items there. So keep talking, and I will actually replace as we need to.
Okay. So I give the bag to Quark to, well, the bag, all the stuff that we have to Quark to identify. Then I turn to Torin and I go, so, who, or just appeared, who know anything? Why you were sent here? You certainly helped us out, don't get me wrong. But
I definitely could have done a lot more than I did, that's for sure.
That's fine, we got out of there. Just know why you showed?
I think it was probably the same issue that brought me here.
Well, I was... Was he in, like, Almraven? Is that what you're gonna say?
Oh, maybe we should give you some background. Well, this whole group, and I kind of gesture to everybody...
Well, that question was for Kalea.
Oh,
okay. Say one more time.
Are we gonna say Torin was in Almraven?
No, you were in a completely different city.
Okay, because I didn't really come up with a backstory for this guy because he was used in a one-shot and then another campaign that just stopped. So I just haven't thought about doing a background for him yet.
I can avoid asking questions about background.
So you'd
like me to.
We're gonna put it this way: whatever city from Torin. You know, and you can use this entire map to come up with your backstory.
He's actually from this plane. That's new.
Yeah, he's from this plane.
Well, I think you're a special case.
Oh. Okay.
So, wherever you choose to be from, Torin, that is where you were transported from. And when you were transported, you got the urging from your god because of a sense of danger that you should, you know, that there were people and beings that you could help through that portal. You were getting a sense of danger about it, but there were people that you could help there. And you were urged to walk through.
Okay.
Okay,
So he kind of relays all that, and I was walking in the middle of town, and portal just popped up right in front of me, and I started to back away, and then I heard my god Mishakal tell me that I was needed on the other side. So because it came from my god, I didn't even second guess it. I unsheathed my mace, and I walked through. And I just ended up inside there.
Thank your god that you did, because it did help us out, no matter what you say.
Mishakal a common god? Like, would we all know who that is?
No. Not common at all. In fact, Mishakal falls kind of in the same vein as St. Cuthbert. Over the years, Mishakal, as well as St. Cuthbert, have been losing followers.
No.
But Ari, you definitely know about Mishakal.
Oh.
Just as a side thing, nobody ever knows who that is. I took the name right out of the player's handbook.
Well,
every time I bring her up, nobody knows who she is. I'm like, I got her right out of the player's handbook.
Yes, but the thing is, Mishakal is more of a Greyhawk god, and
yeah,
we're
like
in favor.
We're in Forgotten Realms. So the way that I've sidestepped that is by these gods are not well worshipped here. They still exist. They still, you know, have some power. Otherwise, you wouldn't be able to do what you're doing. But they don't have a very large follower base.
Okay.
They're the hipster gods. Only
pretty much.
Only hipsters follow them.
That is the exact word I would use to describe Ari, a hipster.
Okay, so that happens. I'm like, well, I don't really know what that whole adventure in the temple is about. And I turn to Quark and I'm like, Quark, can you explain what exactly this stone that I'm holding does? Why we went in there? I went with you guys because you guys attempted to.
So
it's part of what powers the arcane machine that runs this entire realm. Yeah. So
a machine runs the realm.
Yeah. So basically this entire
I'm gonna step in and say planet.
Okay. So this planet is actually a arcane construct that is run by a machine at the center of it. And these are the embodiments of life and the elemental components that are mixed in order to make this planet be a reality.
Let me know when I get back to the camp, Kalia.
You would have been getting back right about now.
Okay, I
just gotten back for him.
Yeah. I see him holding out the stone. I walk over, I take it from his hand, and I will say again.
I don't let him take it.
Well, no.
If somebody's just trying to grab something out of my hand.
I'm not trying to take it. What I'm doing is I'm taking it and I'm trying to hide it in your tunic or in your bag. This should not be brought out ever.
Okay. Can we get the full story on why this we are getting it? As I do tuck it in my tunic. But and then I say, you guys tried to help me, so I'm going to try to help you guys. But I need to know the full story about what all of this is.
You guys just kind of brought me along for the ride. I have no idea what's going on either.
We're trying to save the world.
Okay. Back when this world was created, the elders at my temple teach that it was created as a system of balance. Part of that balance was, for lack of a better term, a machine that kept things moving, kept things alive. In order to do so, these stones, this I learned only recently, these stones are, for lack of a better term, the conduits used to do so. These stones should be in the machinery itself, and instead they were removed, and it was deemed that for life to continue upon this realm, this material plane, that it was up to the beings living within it to find the stones and return them to the machinery. The individual who tipped us off about this entire, I guess you could call it a quest, I do not fully trust. So we are going to gather these orbs and we are going to put them back into the machine ourselves so that they cannot be abused by anyone.
Who was this individual?
He was the advisor to the Pasha.
The Pasha in
Kalimport.
There's Minotaur skeleton one. Okay.
Ari is really intently listening to this because she actually hasn't heard this before yet from Adran.
The stones out. This? I'm asking Adran that.
I you broke up there. I couldn't hear what you said.
Oh, sorry. Who do we think took this away from this first place?
It was apparently the gods because they were like, hey, we made this thing for you, but you guys need to show that you can actually take care of it, so we're going to take out these key components and put them in weird places so that you can go on a scavenger hunt and get them and put them all back and prove that you deserve to live.
Leonis just looks really confused at this point.
Luke just has his jaw dropped a bit and is just like, what?
So, we're here. Where you guys went in that temple to... Okay.
If life is to continue, we need to get these stones back into the machine. The more individuals we have on our journey, the better off we will be. But I will not force you to join us. I have accepted this mission, and I have told you exactly what I intend to do.
Leonis and Adron, as you're talking, you see Stryker leap from a tree that she was in previously, very near to where you and Ari were talking. See her leap from a tree into another tree with a rustle, and we did it very deftly, but you're still able to hear and see this. And she's leaping closer towards the camp now.
I make mental note of what tree she started in, since Ari and I were just there talking. But I continue. This is a mission that I have undertaken. I will not force you to go along with it. The advisor... His words were that this mission came straight from the Pasha. However, I was unable to meet with the Pasha. And everyone I talked to said that the Pasha was more of a hands-off individual, leading me to not trust the advisor as much as I probably normally would. I do plan on keeping these stones out of the Pasha's hands. Thanks to Quark's knowledge, we were able to at least get an idea of a general area of where each of these stones would be. And if you guys would, I would like you to come with me.
Aria, having not formally said this before, after Adron stopped speaking, she steps forward close to him and says to the rest of the group, My God has sent me on this mission for a reason, and even if I don't wholly understand or believe or even agree with what is being said here, I do think that whatever we're about to do is something that has to be done for the good of this world, and so I'm with you.
I reach over, I squeeze her wrist in a thank you, but you know, don't linger, don't try to hold her hand or anything, just a thank you.
A quick, I'm not going to say that because phrasing.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes, exactly what you're thinking. Okay. Jonas is silent.
As Ari finishes speaking, Torin stands up from the base of the tree, wipes his hand off, and then holds it out to Adrian and says, "This is why I left home. And if my God says that you need help, I am in no way to say no. You have me. You have my help."
Adron, you know, clasp hands, nods, and looks at the others.
I'm still silent right now.
Luke shrugs. I ain't got anything better to do. Might as well.
And Luke, by you saying you ain't got nothing better to do, you were realizing that your days were filled largely with just drinking and hoping that the next needed tour guide would show up, or you know, your next gig would show up, for lack of a better term, to pull you out of the drinking and get you doing something.
Quark, what do you say?
I was already in, but I'm waiting to see how many of you guys are joining, because I like you guys, and I think that we should all stick together and be friends.
Oh, I just realized I've been talking as the Minotaur skeleton the entire time.
Yeah.
That's not creepy.
It, but I didn't... Yeah.
Torrin's not going to take anything out of the party inventory, because he just got here. So
I found a cool thing.
Well, I look at Adrana and I say, is Riker with us as well, I'm guessing?
Apparently, only I and Ari saw her leap from the tree to...
Oh, no, I saw her.
It was Leonis.
Oh, it was Leonis.
It was you and Leonis.
Okay.
I have no idea she was spying on us.
Yeah, I saw her leap, but I'm just talking directly to you.
Yeah, she's not on the ground. She's still in the trees, as far as I'm aware.
No, I know. I'm asking you, because you seem to have the closest bond with her.
Oh,
he's not here.
Although I don't turn my head, I sort of flick my eyes up towards the tree.
I understand.
That is a choice that she will have to make. I cannot speak for another person without having had the discussion with them first and knowing 100%.
That's fine. Well, ever since I left my tribe, I've been looking for my own reason. And I think I have finally found it. I will help you guys to the best of my ability to save this world, whatever on it right now. And I put my hand up to Adron, and I'm looking for a handshake.
I clasp his hand and nod as well.
Okay.
Alright, so...
Also, and then I say, so where is Stryker?
Torrin sits back down at the base of the tree.
So, you know, I nod to everybody. I shall return. And then I say a little louder, Stryker, if I could speak with you a moment. And I walk off back to where Ari and I had spoken.
Okay, well, I found some cool stuff here.
What'd you find, Quark?
Want to know about it?
Yeah, what'd you find?
So, there's a cloak of protection. Gives you...
And those are actually tabards. It's not an actual cloak. It is actually tabards.
What are tabards?
You know the leather piece that Anakin wore in Revenge of the Sith?
No.
I'll find you a picture. I'll find you a picture.
I was trying to figure out what you were talking
about. So a tabard is essentially a sleeveless shirt. It doesn't...
So a tank top.
Only without the side pieces. It's like a poncho, only it's slightly narrower than your shoulders.
It's a shirt that you wear over your armor.
Okay.
Yeah.
What else did you find, folks?
So, just for mechanics' sake, would that count as armor?
It gives plus one bonus to AC and saving throws when you wear it.
Yes, but that does... It really matters if it...
It does not count as armor.
Excellent. So, essentially, a Dron could wear it and not take any penalty.
A Dron could wear it.
But he's not there to hear everything, so...
No, you're not.
There's also boots of elven kind.
Ooh, elves?
Yes.
Hey, you're there.
But I don't know if you would want something like this, because it's an arcane object. You have issues with that?
I'm just...
I love this. And you would have advantage on stealth rolls too, and love that you don't want this.
So, technically, boots of elvenkind are not magical items, but they are for terms of mechanics, but they were based off of moccasins. Just for a history note.
Right.
Well,
yeah.
So there's also this cool ointment.
Ooh, can I see that?
Yeah, it's called Kaotorn's ointment.
I think it's Keaton. Holmes.
No, it's pronounced Keaton's with a long E. Keaton's.
Really?
Okay. Yes.
All I could think of was Kaopectate, and I know that was not going to be.
No, it's Keaton's.
This glass jar, 3 inches in diameter, contains 1d4 plus 1 doses of a thick mixture that smells faintly of aloe. The jar and its contents weigh about a half pound. As an action, one dose of this ointment can be swallowed or applied to the skin, and the creature that receives it gains 2d8 plus 2 hit points, ceases to be poisoned, and is cured of any disease.
Sounds very good. Should we give this to somebody who doesn't have always the ability to heal? No offense, Torin, but... It's...
None taken.
If we can... As many people that's even able to heal as possible, help us out in a sticky...
Well, so I already grabbed that potion of healing earlier.
I grabbed one as well. What do you two say? What do you say, Luke?
I'm kind of torn between the not cloak of protection and the boots.
Yo, guys. I'm just saying, if a Dron bot striker present, she might want to talk. She might be a little more open to a conversation.
a Dron's not here.
Yeah, unfortunately, a Dron has no say over the division of things at the moment because he's waiting for you over by the tree.
You made a bad life choice. She's not there no more. Listening to the entire conversation at camp.
Do you say anything, or are you just still up there?
You hear a tiny voice say, "Those boots look really cool."
I thought you went over with a Dron.
You hear the sound of her face palming. No, I was. The whole
You're cutting
time.
Out for me, Anne.
God damn it! That's the worst role. Okay, I was here the whole time.
Was that a deception role?
I'm not sure.
I think we're about to lose her again.
Yes, it was. I just need to figure out how... I rolled for it and sent you the result privately.
Okay, everybody put your insight, anybody that would like to put your insight into the tower for me, please.
I don't like that. Yeah, nope. I rolled a 23. Well, I rolled a 19 plus 4.
Okay, I gotta do this for the first time.
Yeah, if you just...
I probably should have put it in the tower, but oops.
Yeah, if you just click and drag to the tower, it'll roll it there for you.
I rolled it before I realized that she said tower, and then I was like, oops, that was a problem. My apologies.
I think I did it correctly.
I haven't seen anything yet, Torin. Just grab your insight. You can drag the insight skill down into the tower. Yep, there it goes. So, Stryker, as soon as these words leave your mouth, you realize that this is the worst lie you've ever told. And Leonis and Quirk, you realize it as well.
Stryker, gotta try to be...
Torin even realizes it. And he's new to the group.
Did you quibble?
Yes.
Even the stupid thing knows, stupid familiar knows that I'm lying. God damn it.
Okay. You get a rolling eyes from a hawk.
Poor life choices there, Stryker.
Luke is just thinking about getting a drink.
I call up to Stryker.
I climb down from the tree.
What are you saying?
I climb down from the tree and I go, okay, fine, so it wasn't the whole time, but I was mostly there, okay?
You know Adron's waiting for you right now.
Fine, if I have to, I guess.
Go over, talk to him. Tell him. Also, tell him when you get over there that we'll save some items for him to pick from whenever he gets back.
Okay, fine.
Thanks.
Go back to where I was earlier. Oh man.
Are you stealthing up there again, or are you just climbing up and jumping?
No, no, I'm not climbing. I'm just gonna go walk towards the drawing. No, I'm not getting higher ground this time.
Okay. So, yeah, you walk... Are you guys done at the camp for a little while?
Enough or? That we can wait for you to get back.
Okay. So when
anybody else had anything to say, sorry, I don't want to be running the conversation.
Okay, I'll take that as a cue to go ahead. When Stryker walks up, she sees Adron, you know, sitting in the lotus position, or Indian style, or however, whatever words all mean the same thing that you understand.
Does that mean he's at eye level?
Actually, you're ever so slightly taller than him at this point.
Okay, because she's about 3 feet, roughly.
Yeah, you'd be just over him.
Okay, it's fine.
Is everything okay?
You wanted to see me? Sure, I'm just... Yes, everything's fine.
You seem a little upset about something. And I wanted to make sure that, you know, it was not something that I had done.
You like her, don't you? And, Stryker says this, kind of, she's having a hard time saying it. It comes out like she's having a hard time with the idea.
I am intrigued by her, yes. But if there is something I should know, you know, please tell me.
Damn it, all the
If I am a man of honor, and if I am stepping where I should not, I will back off.
You see Stryker's posture kind of relax, and she's struggling with something that she wants to say, but she's having trouble with it, and so you hear it, but it's barely a whisper, which she says, you like her better than me.
I reach out and I pull Stryker into a hug. No, it is not a like better. They like differently. You are the closest thing I have to family at this point in my life. With Ari, it's... I see a chance at a romance that I may not have had in the past. If this is upsetting, then I can set it aside for later. But in the end, we each must follow our hearts. I will not leave you behind. That I swear, no matter what outcome may happen.
You promise?
With everything I have and everything I am, you are my family.
Okay.
I'm only, for lack of a better way of putting it, looking to expand the family.
I like her. She's a little crazy, but I like her. If she'll make you happy, I guess I could be okay with it.
Thank you. And... Oh. This is not anyone leaving anyone behind. This is us growing our circle, making it stronger.
Okay, are you okay, though? I heard earlier what she said.
You were listening, It wasn't a no. To me, it seemed more of a... not trying to speak for her, but the way I interpreted it, and I could be wrong, but it came across to me like a... There's more you have to hear, but I'm not ready to tell you. So, we shall see what comes of it, what doesn't come of it. Only the future knows.
Oh. Okay. I give Adron another, like, a tight squeeze, like, I don't want to let go. And then I just walk back to the, camp without stealth.
Before she lets go, I do, kiss her forehead as I get up and walk back with her.
Alright. So, Adron and Stryker rejoin the party. I'm going to assume that you guys have still been discussing with great interest who's getting what items.
Yeah, from what I've been trying to do this entire time, that was in the chat, like between both the Skype chat and the Fantasy Grounds chat. It's just talk to the people who are still in the camp about what they want, so I can tell Adron and Stryker when they get back.
So they're back now.
Okay. Cool. Welcome back. You guys good?
I believe so, yes.
Okay. Now to the fun part. We have some things that we need to out. We have this ointment that seems to be, from what Quirk said, seems to be a healing ointment. We have this Boots of Elvenkind. I don't think they'd fit me, to be completely honest. And they'll help with dexterity. Like, they just seem to be good boots. Seem to help with stealth. And then we have this tabard. From what Quirk says, it should really help with fights and protection. What do you got? From what I understand, a lot of people are interested in the tabard, and a couple people, of course, myself, Torin. Well, Torin said he's not getting anything, but myself and Quirk probably can't wear the Boots of Elvenkind. And then I'm interested in the ointment, if no one else is. What do you guys say?
If the ointment helps to heal, I could hang on to it. It would, for emergencies. It's not something I really do right now.
Oh, really, Adron? Sorry.
I mean, the ointment...
Sorry, Adron posted that they would adjust the anyone.
Yeah, that's out of character.
Okay.
Yeah, but yes.
I didn't know that, and I'm going to retcon all
I thought we were doing... Okay.
But back to in character. Well, that makes sense. Do you, like, in case somebody gets hurt, would you be able to get to them and heal them up with this ointment, Becker?
I could go in and out without much issue. I'm pretty nimble. Hey,
that's fine with me if it's fine with everybody else.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Ari nods.
Luke shrugs.
Adron also just nods.
Okay. Then Stryker gets the ointment. And I guess we'll put that into her... I guess you'll have to put that into her sheet, Kalia.
I can take care of it, yep.
Okay. Now... The tabard. While I want it, there are more... better people to take this than me. What do you guys want? I'll let you guys decide this.
Well, either the boots or the tunic, either one would be useful for me. However, the party comes first. So, I will leave it up to the rest of you to decide if I should get something or not.
Well, who really needs the armor? Ari gestures kind of to the heavy scale mail that covers her and says, I'm pretty armored up myself. I mean, though I'd like it, I think that whoever needs it should get it.
Out of character, what's your AC?
16.
Adron has a higher AC than Ari does. He has a 17.
No offense, Adron, but I'm trying not to give it to you.
No, that's fine. That's fine. I completely understand. Here's
what's your AC?
Mine's 14.
Mine's 13.
Mine's 15.
I'm 18. God.
Wait, you're 18?
Sorry, I have an 14.
I have an 18 for an AC. So.
Oh my god.
Heavy armor, bitches.
Okay.
So does that put me at the lowest AC?
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
Yes, it does.
Luke, would
can
you...
I has?
Do you say that in character, or do you say that as a person?
Both.
Okay.
I'm just
I didn't realize this. I could have gone into the party sheet earlier and told you exactly who had the lowest AC.
I probably could have done that as well. Oh well.
You guys don't actually see what I'm seeing there.
I'm not right now. Jeez.
We can still see AC, actually.
The order in the XP tab, I think.
Yeah, but in our main party, we can see AC and
perception. Oh, you do actually see the main sheet. Okay.
Yes. If you want it, Luke, you can have it.
Alright, I'll take it then.
Okay. And the boots. These boots seem to be pretty good for staying quiet. Do we want to give this to one of our heavy armored friends?
I know I make a lot of noise when I walk around.
Does that...
It would cancel disadvantage for her. She would be rolling normally.
That's what I assumed. Will that affect you being hit? Would it affect your overall armor that you wear right now?
I don't think so.
She wouldn't be able to wear armored boots with them, but...
Well, yeah. If nobody
does
has
anyone
any
else...
objection...
Yeah. Need them. I'm not very dexterous, to put it moderately.
Personally, I feel that either myself or Stryker should have the boots, simply because they are designed to assist in moving silently, and as Stryker or myself would probably be out in front scouting things out, silence is of utmost importance in those situations.
Well, that is true. If we are moving as a party and we need a stealth, somebody... I kind of gestured to Ari with her... Yeah, I know. We need to... As a group, we need to also be quiet.
I'm fine with either Stryker or Thrawn getting the boots.
And if you want to, it's fine.
Yeah.
I think, so, Adron, you said you're a wood elf, right?
Da.
And these are elven kind, right?
Da.
Those are the same sorts of things, right?
Oh my god.
It in this particular case, the boots of elven kind simply mean that they were either made by elves or made in the same style as elven boots. So that they give us the same sort of
Do they make them pointier?
No.
Oh.
Quark, it's okay.
Did they have chest spots?
They all... Oh. Everybody... All mammalian creatures have these chest spots. They are called nipples. It happens.
Quirk, and I'm like, this is not the time, dude. This is not the time.
Alright, and with that, guys, we're gonna wrap it up for the evening. As the party bickers late into the evening about who gets what items and where nipples come from and what they're used for.
Torin slowly questions why he decided to travel with these people.
Oh, I'm the same way right now, don't worry.
Alright, I want to thank everybody in chat for joining us tonight for Desert Winds. We're here in the 3 hours prior to Critical Role, which is 6 p.m. Central Time, until Critical Role starts, and I will go ahead and get that hosted right now. We'll see you next week, everybody.
Goodbye!
Bye, people!
Bye.